Hey, what is up, Nation? In this session, I'm going to teach you the fundamentals of making a sloped streetscape in Sketchup. Here, I've imported a 3D terrain from geolocation. If you need to know how to do that, there will be a link in the description below. I have another video that walks through how to do that. So just check out the description and you can learn from there how to do that. But this map here is actually of San Francisco. I chose San Francisco because I know it's known for being pretty hilly. The first thing that I want to do is turn off the show terrain. So I just get this flat map. And then I'm going to change camera to parallel projection. Go to camera, standard views, top. And then, because I don't have any lines here, I'm just going to draw these lines. So select that, hit L for a line to draw it, and now I'm hitting M to move and Control to make a copy while I'm moving. So I'm just making this grid here, selecting from top left to bottom right. I'll select only everything that is within that marquee. Looks like there's another street here. I want these lines to be parallel, so I'm just going to copy that line. M for move, Control to make a copy. And then I'm going to close these. They have a solid shape. And I just extended these lines beyond. It doesn't really matter in this particular regard. So the sitemap is locked, which is actually a good thing for right now. Because I don't want to accidentally delete it. I'm just going to fill this in so it's a one single shape. Okay, so I have the basic street layout here. One thing that I think adds a lot is that streets aren't normally square. So if I look down here, you can see there's a little bit of rounding going on. So this doesn't need to be perfect, especially if you're not doing like a very zoomed in streetscape. You just want to give a general feel. So just draw some tangent lines. Just round these guys a little bit. Just gives that extra flair, or maybe not flair, it just shows that extra care that you've thought about something that will be an actuality. Okay, now what we want to do is you want to bring that 3D terrain back and then essentially make a copy of this onto the slope terrain. So to do that, first, we want to turn geolocation and go to terrain. I'm going to turn off hidden geometry here for a second. Go to unlock. So I just right-clicked on this, went to unlock, and then I'm going to explode it. That way we have all this geometry right here. And then I'm going to select my group here. Go to tools, sandbox, drape. It's asking, wow. Select the mesh on which you wish to drape, and that's this guy. So I have this street that is now a separate sort of like group. This is a separate face almost. And that's perfect. So if I try to press P and push pull this, I can't because SketchUp doesn't let me push or pull curve surfaces. So I've installed a Fredo plugin called Joint Push Pull. What I'm going to do is open that. If you need to download this plugin, I'll have a link in the description below. There'll also be a link to of how to install plugins and extensions. So I'm going to select this face and then go in this direction up here to the offset, type in -6 inches, and it's asking me, so it's actually I want to go positive. Oh, it didn't put in the negative. Just put in that negative right there. For whatever reason, it won't accept my negative. Positive or negative. negative, please. I don't know what's going on there. But and then it says press click or press return. So I press return there. I'm going to hit the space bar so I can select this top face and delete it. You can see there's some geometry that didn't quite generate 100%. You can fill that in. Go to View, Hidden Geometry. And then you just want to triangulate these surfaces. So if I connect this guy with this, it should fix both of those. And then select this solid line I just drew and hide it. So do the same thing for all of these. But basically, that's the trick. And then you can come in here and start to add your trees, and you have your satellite image to be able to do that. And the trick here is really to just liven up your streetscape. You know, if you want to come in and put in roads or lines, you can easily do that. So hopefully this helped. If you thought this video was helpful, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video with your friends. And as always, happy hacking.
All right, designers, just because this episode of Designer Hacks is over doesn't mean we're leaving you out in the cold. Tony's got tons of great content available at designerhacks.com. So join Design Nation right now, and we'll see you on the next episode of Designer Hacks.